What's good, YouTube? Welcome to Trendy Topics, where we discuss the latest in hip-hop and gossip. So it's not looking too good for Tory Lanez right now. And we actually see where he's being accused of shooting Meg Thee Stallion in her foot. And remember when they arrested him, she was in the car as well. And there's another footage showing her trying to stand on her foot. And if you look closely, you can see that her foot is injured and she cannot even stand on her feet properly. But as I said, guys, this situation is not looking good for Tory Lanez. It's really a sad situation. But I'm wondering, why would Tory Lanez shoot Meg Thee Stallion? And the reason why I kind of believe this is because she even unfollowed Tory Lanez on Instagram. Now tell me, why would she unfollow him if he didn't do it on purpose? I'm just trying to think around this whole situation, guys. But yeah, at least I'm glad that she's alive. And y'all know that it could have been way worse, because it could have been her heart. It could have been her back. You know, anything could have happened. We all got to remember that a bullet doesn't have eyes to know exactly where it's going. But we also see where Meg Thee Stallion bodyguard, he's speaking out on the situation. He posted up something on Instagram. I'm going to read it to y'all. So he said, "If you know me and you know her well enough, not only do you know I wasn't physically present during Sunday morning event, but you know why. If you don't know me or her well enough, she's good, I'm here now, and she'll never step foot outside without me. Plus, some niggas who don't aim at feet present." So he's taking some shots at Tory Lanez and also letting everyone know that he'll definitely be present whenever Meg Thee Stallion is stepping foot outside. But guys, I want to ask y'all a question. Do you think that it was Tory Lanez who actually shot Meg Thee Stallion in her foot? I guess we'll find out after the popo do their investigation. But I'm really rooting for Tory Lanez. He doesn't seem like the type of person who would do something like that. But you know, you can never know a person too well, especially a celebrity. But that won't keep me from wondering as to why he would shoot her. Maybe it was an accident. That's if he really did it. But yeah, guys, leave your comments and let me know what y'all think about this. And now I want to talk about Rallo. So y'all know that Rallo was scheduled to be released this Friday, but it seems like things kind of take a turn for the worse in somewhat way. So he released a statement on his Instagram saying, "On April the 18th, 2018, I was arrested on a G5 jet. I looked to my left out of the window and seen every top federal agency in the country with guns yelling, 'Rallo.' I said to myself, I guess this is the rise and fall of Rallo, huh? At that moment, I accepted whatever came with this sh-. I looked at my son, my mom, and my girl at visitation. I seen pain. I then prayed to Allah alone to make a way for me. When my lawyer said that I can beat this case, I really didn't believe him because of the cards I had against me. Years later, the judge granted me a bond and I'm on schedule to dismiss my case. I know the world's wondering why the hell Rallo ain't out and I got a bond. My bond has been put under a 30-day review due to all the things I have together. So y'all should see me at the end of August. But the thing that hurts me the most is I can't go to Marlo's funeral, shake my head. I say all this to say God is real, and through prayer, he can make a way even when it's no way." So Rallo is feeling pretty good, even though he's not going to be released this Friday. And he's kind of pissed off that he's not going to be able to attend Marlo's funeral. Now, y'all know Marlo is a rapper. I believe he was 30 years of age, and he was signed to QC, Quality Control, right? We see a lot of rappers reacting to his death, Lil Baby, among others. You know, it's really sad to see rappers being gunned down like that. But sometimes when you do gangster stuff and gangster lyrics, you know, some persons want to test your gangster, even though there's a lot of haters who would like to see your downfall. But yeah, guys, what do y'all think about Rallo being released at the end of August instead of this Friday? And one word of advice to Rallo: whenever you get out, do not come on the internet counting big stack of cash. Y'all remember Rallo used to get on Instagram Live and count maybe like $1 million in cash. This guy would just sit in front of the camera counting money, counting like millions of dollars. You know, you're kind of incriminating yourself, even though it might be legitimate money, but you're just drawing unnecessary attention to yourself. So when you come out, just be humble. Just, you know, just breathe and take it easy. But yeah, guys, as I said, let me know what y'all think about this. So now I want to talk about rapper Boosie. And Boosie did something that I'm really shocked at. Boosie actually created an OnlyFans page. Now I seen Sauce Walker actually created an OnlyFans, and Sauce Walker is over there piping down girls and stuff. which, you know, I ain't mad at Sauce Walker because he said that he's not a rapper. But now to see Boosie creating an OnlyFans page, that kind of shocked me. But he also put out a video saying that any girl wants to see this D gotta pay for it. You know, he was kind of ranting in somewhat way because I guess persons were going at him because he created an OnlyFans page. Maybe they think that the rappers are not as rich as they pretend to be. But yeah, what I'm going to do now is play the video so y'all can hear what Boosie had to say. So check this out.
Worldwide motherfucking announcement. United States, Italy, Dominican Republic, everybody tune in right now. Log on right now, subscribe to my OnlyFans. I got the best OnlyFans in the world. Instagram can't stop this motherfucker. Pussy. Everywhere. I'm so fucking bucked up, man. They just verified my account, man. The fuck you mean, man? Yeah, pussy. Y'all subscribe to Boosie Baddies right now. Everybody subscribe. All my niggas in here, y'all subscribe. It's a subscribing world. Everybody subscribe now and see. Boo Hefner. One more fucking thing. I got ghetto prices. $29.99. Yeah. I'm selling these motherfuckers for $29.99. Yeah. Right. Log on right now. You won't see some real thug wild shit. Log on right now. You better subscribe, I'm telling you. I'm finna go shoot another one right now.
All right, guys, so let me know what y'all think about this. Do you think that rapper Boosie is going broke? That's the reason why he created an OnlyFans page. Yeah, it's kind of shocking to see Boosie over there. You know, he's going to go pipe down girls and all that stuff. But I'm looking to see more rappers going towards the OnlyFans page because over there you can actually be successful. I'm not going to lie. But I mean, it is what it is. Yeah, just let me know what y'all think about this. If you enjoy this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, you can hit the thumbs down button. Also, subscribe to this channel if you have not yet subscribed. And make sure you turn the notification bell on to get notified whenever I post new content. Anyway, guys, I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.